guys, so we are on a trip today. We've been let out for the day and we are at the Harry Potter Studios, if you can see that. We have a guided tour this morning. It's about 10:30. Well, no, it's not even that yet, we're quite early. It is the day where they advised not to travel because of the wind, but it's actually not been that bad. We have managed to park right outside the front, as you can see, because we currently have a rental, an electric car. So we're right in front, which is great. So yeah, we have a tour at 11, so we are a bit early, but we're just gonna chill and yeah, we'll probably go in about 2:45 and suss it out. But yeah. Oh, there's a kid with his little scarf and his wand. It's very cute. We've got our Harry Potter. Oh, you can't even see yours.
No, not yet, because I haven't took it off because it's cold.
I don't know whether to take my jacket for later because I know there's a bit outside, but most of it's inside, isn't it? So we'll catch up with you in here. So we've just come in. They do temperature and bag check. And this is like the main hall. We've got like a little coffee area. And yeah. Darren's just gone to find a guidebook. They are making you wear masks at the moment unless you are exempt, despite the fact that it's actually not a legal requirement, just so you know. There's up these little passports and you go around and you collect the stamps. And yeah, it's actually quite quiet considering it's 10:30. I think a lot of people have been put off by the weather. A couple round there. So this is the current sort of exhibition type thing they've got set up. Is Magical Mischief for the next few months, and they've got Fantastic Beasts over here with some of the outfits, so I'm assuming these are the outfits worn. They've got Newt and Queenie. I've not actually watched the films, I've only read the book so far. They've got this little cupboard under the stairs. There's a spectacle room in there. Is that the real thing that they... I don't think it is it? Is it just the reenactment? We're just waiting to go in. Apparently it's a 20-minute guided bit and then you go round on your own, so...
Yes, it's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous. But yes, they are asking everyone if you to wear your mask, even though not a legal requirement anymore. Hence, we're not wearing them.
We're going in.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is the one, the only, the Great Hall of Hogwarts. It was one of the very first sets ever constructed for the film series, and as you can probably tell, it is also one of the largest. And for the first time ever here at Studio Tour, we have recreated that memorable scene from Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix, where the Weasley Twins burst in through those Great Hall doors, setting off an array of fireworks, finishing with a huge dragon that chased Professor Dolores Umbridge straight back out of those doors you're currently walking through. You may also notice that the lighting and audio sequence is reminiscent of that moment. But the fireworks that you see on screen were actually digitally added in post-production. However, to make sure we've got the best possible reaction from all of the cast on set, we use special studio lighting, just like you're currently experiencing. And as you continue to look up and around the room, you can also see that we've got Fred and George Weasley on their broomsticks in their original costumes, as worn by James and Arthur Phelps for that scene, where they went on to cause lots of chaos and mischief, much to Professor Dolores Umbridge's disdain. Now, just for our Magical Mischief feature, we have a huge new addition here in the Great Hall, and of course, talking about the swinging pendulum here behind me. We first see this swinging in the background in Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, when Harry tries and fails to get his permission slip signed by Professor McGonagall so he can go to Hogsmeade Village. And for the first time in over 15 years since filming commenced on The Order of the Phoenix, the special effects team headed by John Richardson were able to bring this fantastic piece back in. Et voila! Plugs. Now this effect is actually achieved by having an air pressure device built into each and every single one of the desks, and it sets off up to 100 psi, which is pounds per square inch. And if we...
Yeah.
phone looking at all the props. Ooh, Yule Ball is over there. Let's have a look at the Yule Ball stuff down. Chocolate Feast. How disappointing that none of it's real. So it's quite a bottleneck at the start and then it tapers out a bit. We've got the Beau Baton dresses. We've got the proclamations and the staircase. And we've got all the hair and makeup and all the wigs. And yeah, they've even got Wormtail's moles. That's a nice looking jumper over there. They're dyed wigs. So we're at the common room and the chambers.
West Ham blanket as well.
Oh, has he? And Dean Thomas is repping West Ham very well with his blanket and his scarf. I'm assuming this is Harry's here. All the little bits on his desk. All of his West Ham stuff. So they've got all of the wands here. I'm assuming the original ones. They've got the common room for Slytherin. The infamous jacket and hoodie combo. Got the Mirror of Erised.
Gold helps enormously because it gives it
very uncomfy leather couches. Now in Dumbledore's office. Yeah. What am I looking
for? The fountain.
Fountain of Youth. Oh, look at the little elf one. Darren, is this your before and after? And with all the potions. I didn't realise how sort of intertwined all the sets were. Well, here anyway. Oh, the pets. All the animals. Cats. So you've got Hagrid's hut. the broom lifting. All the portraits. All of the cats, dogs and owls. Hagrid's hut. A little pixie in it. Vehicles.
Physical effects, the explosions, the mechanical rigs, the flying rods.
Secret door, the Chamber of Secrets. Lupin's trunk. I love Lupin. Just wave your hand down and don't think you have to iron the dress and knit the... Oh look, the iron's over there. At the knitting. Everything in the burrow.
Emma, come here.
And they've got the clock. Darren's making the pots go. And the little bag. Snakey, scary. Something happens in 2 minutes, Darren. What, the post goes through?
So I think people may in your school have seen several of our factory pets. These include the papers flying up into the air in our great hall, the sound stone, the cool drinks in the potions classroom, and the variety of factory effects going on in the burrow. Now, what is a factory effect? Well, it is a effect that literally takes place live whilst the actors are filming. Unlike a visual effect, which you have a chance to see in a moment, which is done on computers in post-production after the finished filming. So, before this, you want to make sure you can see the front of this door and the letterbox. So if you can't see it, position yourself now and get your cameras ready. You want to be able to see this. Okay. And then what I'm going to show you today is the letters firing into Pivot Drive on the first movie. So when they did this for the film, Christopher...
I feel this is going to be anticlimactic.
However, John Mason...
I feel it'll be a bit anticlimactic.
He disagreed, and he argued that he could do it as a practical effect live during filming. So when he went to the post office and he bought off them two of their sorting machines. And he rigged one for the back of the door and one for the back of the fireplace, and they shot over 1,000 letters into the room. And then what about the others? One, the others, they literally had crew members standing on step ladders behind the top, on the ceiling, over a couple of walls into that set. So over 10,000 letters were used for each scene. So, and now I'm going to show you the effects. So you can really focus on the front of the letterbox. I'm going to start in 3, 2, 1. There we go. So, as I said, they used over 10,000 letters for the scene. And yes, after every single take, the crew had to get down and get into that room.
Here we have Umbridge. Going through the Forbidden Forest now. Oh, this is funny flooring. Darren. The Forbidden Forest. They have a gift shop, and what I smell to be a food, so we're halfway. Cracking. And they've got lots of Christmassy stuff. I think Darren wants a jumper. Hogwarts at Christmas. And they've got all the houses. So we are now on the platform. Very cool. You've got Luna, Fred, so we're getting on the train now. Yeah, except for you can't actually even sit in there. Yeah, but this is the real one, isn't it?
Yeah, it's like
that. Anything off the sweet trolley, dear? Anything off the trolley? Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban when it fogged up. His hand mark on it. Darren! Goblet of Fire. Are you? Take a photo of that.
This was the one with the Dementors.
Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. Half-Blood Prince. Bits that they made. Lockhart's books. So we are now at the Backlot Cafe, which means it's we're halfway through. It's quite a queue around lunchtime, but the menu looks quite nice. Very windy outside. But they mainly just do hot dogs and burgers, and there's a separate queue for butterbeer. Hopefully we can find a place. Looks like they're doing some construction work out there. I got a chicken burger, Darren got a kid's hot dog. Disappointed it doesn't come with onions on. And we got a butterbeer to share.
To share? Oh no!
Looks tasty though, mine. We're back. Do you want to just go over to the house, Darren? The sort of special effects and the creatures. And they've got Luna's hat up there. And some fat costume. I'm assuming the lady that flows away. How realistic the skin is on them.
His nose, I don't know, though. I wonder, they'll probably get loads of spots. Oh, yeah.
It's like the whole thing to the goblins. All the goblins clothes. So this is all for the bank and how they made the bank. And the destruction of the bank. Oh look, this is like the ride down. Like the ride in Universal. We're now in the bank. Oh wow. Hermione and Ron's costumes. The cloak. The cavern and vault. Can hear the motors working.
And multiply had to be a CGI affair. The replicating treasure was something that.
Darren? Oh, Hansel. Oh, sorry, let me. Oh, wow. Okay. In the gift shop. Did you enjoy it, Darren?
Yes, it was good.
Pick out all your wands. So we've obviously been in the shop. We'll show you what we got later. And we're in like the food hall bit. This is obviously a lot quieter, so maybe eat before or after and not get suckered at the middle. And we're just gonna get a drink. And there's some nice little snacks. So this is what we got. Darren got a blondie Rocky Road and I got this cookie sandwich and we're just waiting on our milkshake. Did you enjoy it, Darren?
Yes.
Any advice or recommendations?
Advice, bring your own lunch.
Bring your own lunch, yeah. Or eat in this bit beforehand because it's a lot less busy.
Yeah, it was great food, it was a very long way.
It was alright food and there were sandwiches in that.
Yeah.
But I'd say, I don't think they restrict you from bringing in your own food.
Yeah, just bring your own lunch, a sandwich and just...
Yeah. You could spend hours in there.
The first bit's longer than the second.
Yeah.
It took us about 4 hours to get all together.
Yeah, but we weren't particularly reading everything, watching everything, so it could probably take you longer.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just gonna wait for our milkshake and then when we get home, we'll show you what we got. This is our milkshake to share. Looks very nice, but I'm glad we're sharing one.
Yeah.
So we're all finished now. It's got a lot busier, so obviously come first thing seems to be the option. So yeah, we're heading home, brace the windy weather. The only thing we weren't able to do was when you actually go into the house and you see the living room with all the letters, so that was kind of disappointing. Because I don't actually know if they advertise that that's closed at the moment or whether it was just because of the adverse weather that they didn't let you do it. But
yeah.
I'll investigate that and find out why. But yeah, we enjoyed it, we had a good day, and we'll see you when we're back home.
So we are back home now and I thought I'd show you what we got. So firstly, I'm going to show you my bag that I took because I don't think I actually showed you. This is the Danielle Nicole backpack. Let me take my coat out. This is the backpack. They do sell these at the studios. I got mine when we were in Florida. But yeah, I think this is only like the second time I've ever used it. But it's pretty cute and fit the occasion. So a little freebie thing you can get are these magical mischief passports and you basically go around the different sections and you can stamp it. But what we did at the start wasn't correct and we put the whole book in where you're actually supposed to just do one page. But anyway, you live and learn. So we got those. These were our photos that we got. This was me on the broom, couldn't resist. And then this one was pretty cute of me and Darren. But comes with, like, in a little booklet. A nice one of us together. I wish there was more actual photo opportunities, like, even if you had to pay for it, like, especially outside the castle bit, but oh well. So got those. I got the official sort of guidebook right at the end, so I can read that. That was $9.95. I got this, which is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, like a little frame with a cell in it, and we've got a couple of these, but downstairs is all sort of movie Hollywood themed in our bathroom, so we're going to pop this in. It comes with a film cell, I don't know if you can see, but it's got Harry in when they're in the zoo when he talks to the snake, and they had lots of different cells and things like that. Then I got myself a pin. They had a lot of sort of similar stuff to what is at, obviously, Harry Potter in Florida. But I got this because this is like more of a newer one. It's even got, you know, the Universal Studios back on it. That was £7. Darren picked up the Gringotts chocolate coins. I'm not sure how much these were. I'll have a look at the receipt. And then I picked up the exploding bonbons, which I really like. These are £8, which is quite pricey, but that's what they are, and they are super good. And then let me unwrap. He got a bubble beer to try. A butter beer. And this is like their exclusive design, I think. Designed, I guess, by Minalina. It's a butterscotch flavour sparkling soft drink, which is actually the nicer bit out of the butter beer. I don't really like the foam on top anyway, and when we go to Florida we get the frozen ones, which are a whole lot nicer and less sickly. So I wasn't actually that thrilled with the shop. I thought there was a lot of empty shelves, a lot of stuff that wasn't really exclusive to the tour, which I would have hoped for, you know, things that actually said Warner Brothers tour on it. It was just a lot of general Harry Potter merch that you can buy on the website and at the park, so yeah, not really that exclusive. And I just didn't think they had a great range of things. I thought they were going to have a lot more than they did. So yeah, I was kind of underwhelmed with the shop. That being said, we still bought stuff. So yeah, I'll wrap up this vlog now. I hope you enjoyed sort of coming along for this little journey. I forgot to mention these were tickets we got for Darren as his birthday present, so this was like his birthday treat. But yeah, so I hope you enjoyed coming along. We would definitely want to go back at some point, especially seeing as that there was possibly bits that we missed out on. So yeah, I think Christmas would be a good time to go when they decorate it all and that. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll see you very soon. Bye guys.